Hello and welcome along. Today on Nutston Farm, we are going to be taking a little bit of a break from sorting out bales, and we are going to be harvesting our barley crop on field 4. We have the T6160 set up on course play, and we're going to be controlling the combine. So without further ado, let's get started. So we'll turn on our combine. Ooh, turn it down. There we go. So yeah, we are going to control the combine around the field. Turn the straw off, because we don't need to get straw off this field. We have quite a few bales from our last field 1, and we'll go and pick those up later, but for now we have this nice big field of barley that needs cutting, so we will go through and do that. And it makes a nice change from all the bale work that we've had both here and on American Outback for the last couple of episodes. It makes things a little bit different and changes it up slightly. Course, the tractor on course play means we should be able to just enjoy using the combine for a bit. Let's just look at this harvest for this. This is from a pack of New Holland harvesters. And it's a nice little pack. I think it takes a wider, yeah, so you can put a wider cutter on this combine as well. It has space for that, but because of the size of this farm, initially we've gone with a smaller header on the combine. Still working towards our cows on this map. When we get off this field, we may be able to sell a bit of it. So we only have 16,000 left to get the cows themselves. The bottom of this field is slightly funny shaped. So I may end up doing this bit first and then so with course play we can request drivers as well. The only thing I dislike about course play is how it misses bits in the corners when you're seeding. Press driver. See. That's the other thing about crossplay. He's working his way through the crop. At least it doesn't have crop destruction for a crossplayed tractor. Ooh, we're not. Yeah. We might wait for him for a moment. May cause problems. Because he is heading into the bushes. Yeah. Okay. Emptying, excellent. Doesn't seem to like going around the corner. And it looks like we have to move him out of the way as well. He is now waiting until the next time I'm full, which will probably be the other end of the field. Always taught the bit to watch is the left hand tine. So long as you can see that you know you're cutting enough of the field. I love the in-cab view of the combine. It's a nicely realistic place to be in Farming Simulator. It's the kind of thing where I think that a VR helmet would be absolutely awesome in this game. And I kind of wonder whether FS17 will have VR support, because that would be an incredible way to play this. Make it very immersive. Coming up to the end of our first round of the field, which will also be not far off our second tank. So I would guess that, 52% the trailer took from our first round. I would think that it will probably take, probably fill to the point where it will go and tip it. When it fills up next. So off a single around, that is not bad. Now, is he going to come and try and fill at 80? So he should be watching. Yep. We'll put the spout out. Whether he reaches us before we're full again, I don't know. He's coming. So we're going to do 3 rounds of the field before we start cutting in. It gives us enough space to turn around. Ah. Whoa! I missed 100%. Still using the West trailer. The Marshall trailer has just been released, which I like a lot. They're the same trailers that we used on my dad's farm, and I very much would like to use those. I've decided that for now I'm going to hold off. I have an idea for a map a little bit down the road where I want to use the Marshall. And so for now, I'm going to keep using the West trailer on that stuff. Oh dear. Where's he got stuck? That's the thing. 3 rounds of the drive now. There we go. So I have a map that I wish to use those later. For now, we're going to continue using the West trailers on Nutston. I think got the cows, we might start looking at what field we're going to buy next. So if we can get working on the third field. I'm not sure what episode we're up to. I think this is around 17. So I don't know how many more we'll do. We might do up to 30. As we're now running this map only twice a week. We'll see how we go. Sadly, we'll play this for a while yet. There's still a lot to explore, even with its sort of very standard setup. Lift the header at the end, so we'll make sure that we have the header selected. So this is quite a big field for. I think our two episodes this weekend will probably be focused on harvesting this field by the looks of things. So we've got round to the bottom again. Probably get the headings done this episode. A nice big amount of barley up here, I think. Always half a field away, unfortunately. Hear him, and he's slipping. It is one of the biggest issues with course play. It would be nice if it could detect obstacles and go round them, get out of the way. No, still not working. Driving into do not know where this tractor is going. We'll drive it under there ourselves. Drive it under there ourselves and then we'll leave it. Yeah, doesn't seem to want to do anything other than drive into the headrest. Drive into the wall as much as it likes. We'd get another round on this field, but I think we're only going to get two runs in the headland at this point. Started on our next round of the headland. Started. that. Trailer load off the field. Offset control tire. Looking for the offset for the trailer, so we move the tractor over a little bit. It appears that that's set in a slightly different place. It's set on the tractors, horseplay, not on the combines. So three rounds on this will almost immediately take off, and almost completely separates this bottom end. Go a little bit longer and see if we can make it back to complete this headland. Then we can concentrate on doing the main body of the field in tomorrow's episode. Harvester in a similar way. Might need to hire the harvester to do it, but I think that might be a good thing to do on this field next time we plant it. We'll see how much money we raised, and maybe we'll have enough to buy a topper and a harvester. run it the same way with a course play tractor and running the beet harvester. Here it comes. I don't think the tractor's going to get here before we're full again. And that's if it manages to steer clear of the... It has steered clear of the hedgerow this time. Well, and that would be a good place for us to end this episode. Well, that's it for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please give us a like, leave us a comment, and share the episode. And for all the latest Virtual Farmer videos, please subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.